Yo. Yeah, what's good? It's the Hard Food Podcast.
Back again. That's loud.
My name is Juice English.
Saxon King there.
This is episode 24.
Yeah.
Yo, how come we never know the number?
I was just missing to one.
Yeah.
I just lost count.
Episode 24, you know.
I can hear some reverb.
Yeah, I don't mind it still, but as long as the mic, so I'll pick it up. But, yeah, man, what's good?
Well, you can hear me breathe. Anyway, but yeah, you know, just diet, usual, consistency. Just going on, man. It's like last week, or a couple of weeks ago, I bought some new meal boxes. Because I'm a six-pack bag man.
Mm.
And all my meals are in that. If you follow me on social media, you know what I'm talking about. And I went for a little smaller size meal and whatever. And can y'all hear me now?
Yeah, you just...
That's good. The reverb's gone.
So you know before that, yeah, was it picking up the...
It would sound weird.
Yeah, it should be all right.
But yeah, basically, made the meals a bit smaller. So when I'm at work, yo, I'm hungry now.
Yeah.
I'm like...
So you guys seem to be happy when you came in here this morning and stuff.
Like, hungry. Yeah. Like, you know when you eat, and then by the time you sit down, you're hungry again. This is the state that I'm in.
Yeah, I ain't gonna lie, I ain't been hungry in a while. I've been eating mad, you know. I might need to go back to this vegan challenge thing, you know, because
don't do no vegan challenge.
I need to find a balance in the middle, healthy. Fam. I ain't gonna lie.
Just eat healthy.
Yo, I don't even know if I should. Yo, I've had so much junk food, like this week, fam. Last night, I don't know what's wrong with me. You know, I need to go to doctors.
You're eating crap.
but fam, I went to Mackey's last night.
That's the problem.
That's the problem as well, but. I had like 5 chicken selects, yeah, and a double cheeseburger. Finished it, got up and ordered the next burger for the road. Like, what's wrong with me, man? And I'm just not.
No, you're eating rubbish. That's why.
But it's not fully filled. It's not touching the sides
it
at all. Man.
Like, it's not proper food.
But it's just easy for you, man. Like when you're busy now, yeah. I don't know. I can't do. When I'm busy, it's just quickly. I'm literally driving to anywhere that's serving the quickest food. I'm going Subway, I'm going Mackey's. I live in Subway and Mackey's.
It's because you're not prepared.
Nah, I'm not prepared at all.
When I wake up, this is my day. Yeah. I get up in the morning, as y'all know, who follow me on social media, I do my AM cardio. Do my cardio, have my breakfast, yeah? Which is porridge and protein.
Mm.
Then go work. I have 4 meals at work. Then... It depends. Sometimes I might have 3 and just hold off 1 meal.
Mm.
And then I'll get back home from work, sort out the kids, get them to bed. Then I'll train and have a meal before I go to bed. But before that, while I'm sorting out the kids, I put chicken in to cook.
Mm.
So the chicken's cooked, done, boom, come back from gym. Sometimes I reach back from the gym like 10:30, 11 o'clock. And then I'll do my cardio at home.
Psh.
Then after that... Instant reaction, that was... Then after that, sorting out my meals for the next day and pack them all up and boom, the cycle.
I'm going to say, are you giving away secrets here though?
No, because you know what it is? Here what? This is one thing about bodybuilding.
Mm.
Yeah. Regardless of what you do, once you get like, after you've been doing it for a certain while, everyone knows what everyone does.
Yeah, you know what I mean?
And it's like, basically, it's not like a secret ingredient.
Mm.
And ultimately, genetics does rule it, because a man can be stacked, like wham, whamadocious, and still look rubbish on stage because of the way he's born.
Yeah, so we'll carry it different. Yeah.
Now, all the training in the world ain't going to make your waist smaller.
Mm.
All the training in the world is not going to make your shoulders broader, because you ain't having an operation to put no extra like bone in your shoulders to make them wider, to make you look bigger.
Mm.
So it's just how it is. Some guys don't get it. They think, yo. Some guys think, yo, let me just jump on this mad juice here, and then everything's going to be sorted. No, it's not.
Wacky backy. No, the steroids.
It's ridiculous because at the end of the day, this is the way I see it, yeah. Hear what, yeah. You see me? Obviously, I'm natural and whatever, but I don't care if a man's on juice. I really don't care because the way I see it is that if a man wants to choose to do juice, he'll do juice. Mm. Who am I to sit there and say, pause. Yo, you can't do that, yeah. You can't do that, yeah. You can do this, you shouldn't do that. Because at the end of the day, yeah, that's the same way me saying, yo, you can't drink alcohol because that's not good for you. But people view it differently. You see what I'm saying?
I'm part of you.
Now, when it comes to training and dieting and doing shows, people might say, yeah, but Adrian, you're at a disadvantage. Yeah, fair enough, but that's still my choice.
Mm.
I know that. The judges know that. The judge is not going to give me, like, oh, well, he's natural, so we'll give him an extra point. No, they don't. The judge what they see.
Okay, I thought they did that, to be honest.
They don't. The judge what they see. And if I do a natural show and they see me up there, they'll be like, yo, Adrian Big Sir.
Mm.
You know what I mean? Are they going to take off a point of me because I'm more genetically capable of putting on muscle compared to the next guy who's not?
Yeah.
It's not. At the end of the day, every man trains, every man diets, every man does his thing. And regardless of what they say, the best will be the best. The best in the world at the moment on juice, there would have been, even if they're natural, they'd still be one of the best in a natural federation, end of. Even if they're the one to do it, doesn't matter. So anybody out there, saying that steroids is cheating, yo, it's only cheating, if you're juicing and doing a natural show. And to be fair, if you did that, you're a bit of a, like, an idiot because you're just stupid.
Yeah.
Because really, it's not that deep. You know what I mean? People say to me, yo, you must be on juice blood. I'm like, no. If I was, I'd tell you.
Yeah.
I'd be quite honest. I don't care. I'm at that point. I don't care.
Sound like you really want to get this off your chest.
No, you know what it is? You know what it is? You know what it is? I was talking to one brother today about it. I've got bare people arguing, over me.
Okay.
Like arguing, man, nah, he's natural. Nah, he's not. No, he's not. And I'm like, yo, bro, if I wasn't natural, I'd tell you, I'd rather tell you, because the people and the circle that I'm in and the people in the industry, the people that I know, we don't care. You know what I mean? It's not a big deal. If you want to do it, you do it. If you don't, you don't. Done. Now, when people want to argue, I'm like, yo, is me being on juice or me being natural that much of a big deal for you? I take drug tests. I get polygraphed. Yeah, and I'm not that good at, like, I'm a guy that just tells the truth all the time.
Mm.
You get me? That's why you never see me lie about Arsenal. I'll tell them they're just pagans. But it's a case that you don't. There's no big deal, man. Just do your thing. Everyone do your thing. Everyone love life.
Work
everyone
hard.
Be positive. Work hard. No negativity.
I think that's,
you don't need that.
I think the condensed version of what you're saying is basically work hard.
Work hard. Do
and
your thing.
And it don't even matter.
It don't matter.
It don't matter.
I mean, live life. Love life.
All right. Let's say happy birthday to Spock.
Yes.
Whoa! Happy birthday.
Happy birthday to you.
It's a J.A. rendition.
Yeah, man, happy birthday, Spock.
Happy birthday, man. Big man.
I saw a Facebook status.
Hey, you posted this?
No. From
TLC.
Oh, TLC. What did he say?
TLC posted a status.
About you, Spock. And you know what? This is how I know, that Spock is a G.
You looking for it?
He's a G,
This is the big statement still. So TRC asks, yo, Spock, what kind of music are you into? And Spock replies, I only hear two types of music, good music and bad music. Oi! Legendary statement. Big boy says still.
You get me?
Nah,
thank you, Mr. TRC. Yeah, we've been spending some time in the studio. He's a GGG.
Yeah, he is still.
Right,
man, right there, that still. So, I'm gonna have to apologize to Adrian right now. Still, I said, man, Adrian messaged me yesterday. I said, yo, fam, We ain't talking about Takeshi 6ix9ine ever again, you know.
Don't want to talk about this pay, yo.
We ain't talking about this guy, you know.
Nah.
Not on my platform.
Bun him.
Nah, blood.
Idiot.
Nah, blood.
What's he done now?
Oh, I could say, I could say some words, but...
He went on to...
he's just an idiot, man.
He went on to the Breakfast Club.
He's a...
Once.
Beanhead. That's me being nice. I mean, man's just an idiot.
Okay, here we go. I'm playing the tune, you know, so it's going up.
Here we go.
Niggas envy off.
Jeez!
I don't care about his music, you know. I really don't even care about his music. His music is not my issue. I don't like it. It's not my vibe. But I can understand people will like it. I get it. But it's just him. He's just an absolute tool.
See, this is what I'm struggling to understand right now, yeah. Why do you not like him?
Because he's just a... He's a fairy. That's all he is, you know. He's a gooned up fairy. He's got goons around him. He's just a fairy himself.
But elaborate, because like...
You know what it is? All right, then, cool. You know what it was. Here what, yeah. He is like this generation's... Like, he typifies this generation coming up. Yeah?
Okay.
Because I'm not knocking him in terms of, you know, he's... Him saying he's self-made. I get it.
Mm.
That's fair dues. Fair dues to the kid. Fair dues. You know what I mean? I've never stated that he's not.
Mm.
I've never said that he's got a massive cosign. But... Yeah.
So what don't you like?
He's just a knob.
Why? I need to know why. It's like Jada Smith all over again. It's like...
Nah. I dislike this guy. I don't dislike Jaden Smith, but yeah. I dislike this guy.
Why?
I don't dislike his music. It's not his music. Is not my vibe.
I can't understand because you don't like. I don't get why you don't like him.
Because he's a knob.
Why? How is he a knob?
Absolute knob.
Look, you know what the thing is. Everything he says, yeah, is facts.
He's a knob, though.
Yeah, man. Everything he releases,
he's just a knob.
Charts, is self-made, like you said. No call sign. Everyone hates him.
He's just a knob.
It's actually, and you know the thing is,
it's not even what it was. Okay, he's just a barefaced liar as well. He's a liar.
That's all.
Yeah, because now don't get me wrong, yeah. Don't get me wrong. Yeah, I don't live in LA. Yeah.
Yeah.
I live in Wolves. I'm from the ends. Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, from what we know of LA gang culture, yeah, you can't, yeah. Be in a set, cripping, fully blued up, and then just think, I'm gonna change my squad, change my mates. But the thing is, yeah, if you got friends on both sides, fair enough, yeah. But the fact is, you've got to be conscious of that, and realistically. If you've got friends on both sides, you're not dressing like either. Just wear black all the time.
Nah, but he says his blood.
So what's
it's cool? It's cool with Crips.
He's cool with Crips. So he's dressing like a Crip before.
I don't know. Was he actually wearing blue?
Or
in that video?
His head was blue.
Blue bed sheets.
Blue.
he had blue bandana bed sheets.
Poundland business. He had blue bed sheets. He had blue clothing, fully Cripped up.
Yeah.
Now, don't get me wrong. Yeah, I'm not saying, like...
So is that irks you?
It's just him as a person as well.
What?
I don't like him. And it's like when he said, something about when, if you're X amount of age, and you have to get the charge, you know, I might as well have took it because I'm younger, da-da-da-da-da. And he said, stuff happened, it was crazy. No, you're lying. I don't care.
You don't know
why
that.
Are you going to have a 14-year-old girl lying across your lap? Yeah, and you're the guy in that squad.
He said that she lied about her age.
I don't care. And then so all of a sudden he did nothing with her.
I think he never said that he did anything with her.
He said he did nothing with her.
Yeah, doesn't Dennis always
say
that?
He says
we don't know.
I don't care. Nah, I'm not buying it. I don't believe him.
And it's a.
I don't believe him. I think he's raw lying.
Okay, well that's neither here nor there.
So that way he'd be a child molester. Boom, boom.
Okay, but he was 18 at the time. She's 14, lied about her age.
I don't care.
It's like, well, no, it's different. It's not like you're, like, 45 or something and you got young girls in your area. You should be Like, it's probably just all around that circle.
Breaking law is breaking the law.
Nah, fair enough, but...
like, me. If man can go to the pen, yeah, for selling a small amount of weed, yeah. Breaking the law is breaking... Yeah, and breaking the law is breaking the law.
Yeah, that's fair enough. That's fair enough. Mate.
And, but, and to be fair, yeah, he's just a knob.
How else is he a knob? Absolute knob. You know what? I'm gonna
lie. Like, don't get me wrong, yeah. I don't mind people getting tattoos, yeah. But he's got a flipping 6ix9ine tattooed all over it. It's an absolute...
Look at all these Mexican gangbangers that we see, man. They're all tatted up all over the face, man.
I cannot stand him. I cannot stand... And you know what it was as well?
I mean, went up to the Breakfast Club and bust it.
No, he didn't bust it.
He busted.
He didn't bust it. He didn't bust it.
He dictated the interview.
No.
We've both seen how Breakfast Club interviews go.
You know what it was? It's because, yeah... He was trying to play it down like as if Charlemagne's just some waste guy. And it's because it's the attitude of this young generation. Because of that flipping, like, mug academics trying to hype him up. He's another knob as well.
Wait, so the course, man.
He's another knob.
Hey, Breakfast Club. Let's allow academics right now.
He's a... absolute wally.
Yeah, so...
Yeah, the thing is, yeah, my point is,
he went on to the Breakfast Club. You can't decide.
You didn't dictate
it. He dictated the interview?
It didn't, man. I don't care.
We've seen how Breakfast Club interviews go.
Because the thing is, you know what? The thing is, the reason why I say he didn't dictate it is like, yeah, he stated the facts. I understand that. Yeah. I'm not disputing that. It's just that when... It's like the part when he said, he come out and said, oh, well, I come with all my big talk, but if you're going to set me up, I'm not going.
Yeah, that's facts, man.
No, if you're a bad man...
No, that's stupid. He said I'm gangster, but I'm not stupid.
No. If you're as bad as you talk, yeah, you turn up.
Nah, that's stupid. It's not stupid.
If you're as bad as you bad, if you're bad as you say you are, you turn up.
No, if you got beef...
If he's saying, I will pull up anywhere.
Yeah.
And he's not. So what's the lip for?
Fam, if you got beef with Spock, yeah... And then,
yo, if you're,
and then,
if you're talking the hardest, saying, yo, I will pull up anywhere, and you don't pull up, don't come with the chat.
He turned up,
but he didn't even go out there.
He went to the door, innit? Fam, listen, if you got beef with Spock here, and Molyneux book you to perform with at the nearest location, and then you got, like, someone bars you, yo, Spock's on the stage, you know, Spock's calling out, yo, where's my man, like, it's obviously a setup, so you phone a promoter, yo, I'm hearing Spock's on the stage, you got security set up, because it's just me and two guys, and I'm not about to walk into this, where the guy's like, nah, there's no security. You're going to turn up.
They call two extra man to say, yo, we're going there.
No, you're in Houston. You're in Spock's end. You're not care. Even...
I'm still going out there.
Nah, fam. That's stupid. See,
no, but that's stupid. It's not stupid because the thing is, that's back in my talk.
Fam, where are you going to go walk in Spock's hometown, Spock's stage, because Spock's waiting is, for you? Yeah, you want to go there and get
if
your money?
If I am the person hyping up myself... Yeah. If I'm come with all the social media gas, I pull up there. Yeah. I ain't afraid of nobody. I'll do this. I'll do that. Then I will go out there. If I'm coming with a talk. If I'm not coming with a talk.
It's not stupid, man. It's gangster. It's not stupid. As he says.
Gangster's walking out there.
Nah, that's stupid. That's stupid.
No, it's not.
I know the mafia bosses. You think the mafia bosses are about to walk into a cell?
Gangster is backing your talk. And that ain't backing your talk.
It's backing his talk. He pulled up. He went to the door.
Yeah.
The event's like, yo, there's no security for you. And your enemy's on the stage waiting for you in his hometown.
Okay.
You get me? Like,
if you're bad enough, you just go up there with enough money.
And take the bang. You're going to get banged. You're going to get banged.
But that's what... Even so, you still take the L?
Nah, but that's stupid.
Nah.
That's like toxic masculinity. You get me? Like...
Nah.
Nah, but fam, why are you going to walk into a location where you know you're going to get banged?
Because you come with a talk.
Nah.
Once you've come with a chat, you have to back it.
No, but it's like... There's backing your talk. It was in Houston, you get me? But like, he went to the door. And the event should have the security for him. Should the event not have security for him?
If he's as bad as he says he is, yeah. If he's as bad as he says he is, he'd walk out.
Fam.
If you ain't that bad, don't come with a chat. And if the thing is, you know what? If you're going to a place, you know that Jay Prince and his man them are going to be there, yeah? You're in his town.
Yeah.
Why don't you roll there certified, just in case?
Because he's just letting his balls hang, as he says.
He lets his balls hang. That's what he says. So what happened when there was no security? The shovel back up in him.
In fact, we just don't walk into an event where you know you're gonna get drunk. Why would you walk into a setup? Why
would you? If he says he lets his balls hang, yeah. So if you're letting your balls hang, you walk out the same way.
Fam, it turned away and got paid the same way. Why am I performing?
Okay. I don't care. That's not my point. Ain't getting paid.
Fam, yeah? Why am I gonna perform? Why would anyone go and perform?
Letting your balls hang, letting them swing. So yo, I'm the baddest, you know. I'm the bad boy. What?
He didn't even say he's the baddest. No. He said, fact, yo, I'm not checking in.
Pull up.
He pulled out. He was there.
Yeah, but he didn't walk out on stage because he was shook.
Why would you walk on stage when the man
was shook?
When Spock's there waiting for you?
You're shook.
Why would you?
Because you've come with a talk.
Yeah, you came with a talk, and I said, yo, I'm gonna pull up to your city. I'm in your city now.
Yeah.
The event that I'm meant to be making my money at is not gonna secure my safety.
Okay. So what? So all of a sudden you catch frayed and it's like, oh, fam, I'm scared now, so we better run off.
Fam, it's smart.
You know what I mean?
Why would you go on the stage and get attacked?
When they're running so fast that their legs just go.
Fam, you gotta be smart out here, man.
Nah, man.
Then
don't come with a chat.
Fam, we just said I'm pulling up. I'm anywhere.
Nah, I'm sorry.
And
nah.
To be honest, and actually, if his story is correct, I don't know. I can only believe it because he said it. That happened before there was even any J Prince beef. Because he said he's seen him in.
So in that case, why didn't he walk out?
No, he said he's seen him in Foot Locker or wherever shop it was.
Yeah.
J Prince was there. He was there for half an hour, just waiting, not even buying our shoes. Takeshi left.
Yeah.
J Prince left. Why didn't J Prince do something there then? Now he's on the stage saying, yo, where's Takeshi? I can't wait. You know what I mean?
So if there's not issue there, what would you think there's an issue there?
Because J Prince is on stage saying, yo, where's Takeshi? Where is he? It's calling him out on the stage.
So if he's bad as he says he is, you walk out on the stage.
Why would you walk out on
the
stage?
Because you're backing your talk.
What was his talk? There was no talk before that. He pulled up.
No, I'm not about in general. He says he will pull up anywhere. So you pull up and you walk out.
He pulled up.
Nah, man. That's some funny boy talk, man.
He pulled up.
Don't come
He came to the venue.
So what? He pulled up. So pulling up is getting there.
Fam, he got there and there's no security.
So he got there, no security. Oh, what's that? Oh, what's this? Oh, something's happening in my groin. Oh, my groin. my balls are starting to shrink back up. Oh, I think I'll have to turn around and go home.
Fam,
I'm getting paid anyway. Shut
what,
up, man.
What would you do? What would you put your safety at risk?
He ain't thinking about his safety when he's chatting all his rubbish on social media.
He said, yo, I'm a gangster. I'm pulling up.
If you're a gangster, you walk out.
He pulled up.
No.
He turned up. He
you
was
walk
there.
Walk out on stage.
Why?
If you are gangster.
When you know there's a man there, you don't do them things and you don't do them things.
Nah, because this is what I'm saying. He ain't. It's like.
You just don't like him.
No, it's not just that.
It's the hair in it. You don't like the rainbow hair. Don't get me started on that boy
on his physical appearance.
Don't get me started on his physical appearance.
Yeah. Yeah, with them hairy moobs. Yeah. I don't know why he likes to have his shirt off. Put your shirt on.
It's the rainbow hair in it, the rainbow teeth.
Don't get me started on him. He's a mug.
Man, don't want to taste the rainbow.
He's an absolute mug. And you know what it is? It's a case that all of these people sitting there and they're saying, yo, he ain't one of us, you know.
Who's saying that?
Like, did you see the video that YG made yesterday?
Yeah.
Put out.
Oh, no, I didn't see it, but I heard about it.
Now, I've seen a lot of social media people saying, oh, why is Game getting involved? Why is YG getting involved? Y'all have got kids,
Family's got grown man shook.
Now, Game's on tour. So, Game's not going to shut him a box through social media when he's in Denmark, is it? And did he perform in London?
Game, I don't feel like
because that. Migos were in London, yeah.
So, I don't.
Yeah, they were in London the other day. But anyway, Game, as I was saying, yeah, what it is, the way I see it is that someone has to say something to say, yo, he ain't blood, you know. This and this person from LA, yeah, we ain't claiming him.
Well, yeah, that's...
We need to hear some... I haven't seen anybody from New York Bloods say anything. Still. You get me? We haven't seen nothing. But the LA man, them, like, yo, we ain't claiming him.
He ain't getting touched.
It's only a matter of time.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's
it's a matter of time.
That's a different conversation. But
what I'm saying
is at the moment he's back in his talk.
I don't want to see. No, he's not back in his talk. He didn't walk out. I don't want to see it. Even though he's an absolute fairy and he's a mug, yeah. If someone does something to him, boom, him gone. That's a life wasted.
Nah, I don't want to see him get killed.
Yeah,
I want to see him hold a few thumps, though. Nah, because I want to see how his talk changes. Cause I'm not even disagreeing with you. Yeah, he's got the most talk. What I'm kind of saying is, fam, he hasn't lied. Yeah. I feel like he's backed all his talk. Like again, he's gone to the Breakfast Club. Breakfast Club.
But there's nothing.
No. Breakfast Club are known for bullying the artists when they come around. You get me? Man, come to the Breakfast Club and get bullied. Charlamagne clowns, man.
You know what it is? I don't think Charlamagne like bullies people.
I'm not like excessive bullying.
He's just like he talks to them directly, and the way that certain questions are like angled, he won't do that. He'll just ask a direct question. Now, with what he was trying to say, it's like when he said, if it wasn't for Breakfast Club, I wouldn't know about you. Well, if he wasn't making music, no one would know about him.
Yeah, but
at the end of the day, the fact is that if someone doesn't do the thing that they're most known about, why would anyone know about anybody? Absolute fool. His point made no sense.
In a way, the thing is, it doesn't even have to make like the clearest of sense.
The hair dye must have penetrated. It has
to make the clearest of sense. He rattled Charlamagne. Charlamagne ain't been rattled before, you know. Mm-mm. Fred Ross Star was there shouting at him. Mm-mm. Master P was there putting him on check. Birdman was there.
He didn't rattle him.
You watched these Breakfast Club interviews, didn't it? Not rattled him. He got under his skin.
I don't think he's got under his skin.
Charlamagne ain't the kind of person to be like, yo, I do this, I do that. Charlamagne never has to say that.
It's a case that I don't think he got under his skin because he's still composed, he's still calm, he's allowed to speak. Now,
Charlamagne's a Jew.
When it comes to rattling someone and getting under their skin, they're getting angry, they're getting anxious, they're getting like, you can see something building.
No, not tonight.
All it is just stating facts.
No, it's not.
With what he was saying, He just shows, that's what he said, I'm too old for this. Because he just shows an ignorant young boy. He's just ignorant.
Yeah.
Ignorant and young and stupid.
But people don't go up to Breakfast Club and have Charlamagne feeling that way.
No, but you can tell that the consensus was from the start. It wasn't what he was saying. Because Angela Yee was talking to you and then Charlamagne came in. Because it's like, yo, you're just young and ignorant. You are what the negative side of this social media platform has produced.
Yeah, the trolling.
You know what I mean? Like the trolling era is massive and it's bigger than ever. But what happens when people start getting touched up, because of this trolling talk?
They don't even care.
You see what I mean?
They don't even care.
Now, if that's the thing, it's a situation, when Biggie and Pac died now. This is nowhere to comparison, but you just got to understand.
I'm going to compare it a bit.
The point is that when Biggie and Pac passed, it's like, yo, this is deep. You get me? And their talent was what shone first. This kid, people aren't talking about his talent. They're talking about the crap he's talking.
Nah, see, the thing is, you know what it is with Tekashi 6ix9ine?
He's a knob.
You know what? People always say, yo, what if Tupac was around in this time and Tupac had Instagram and Tupac had Twitter? Just imagine. Because I know if Tupac had Twitter, not to say he'd be as bad as Tekashi 6ix9ine, probably nowhere near, but he's going to be on that, you know, flags in the camera and...
But the thing life, is, but this is what I'm saying, but he's going to be on that. I think if Pac was alive in this era, if the beef came, Pac would be on the front line.
How can we say that? We don't know that.
No, because you got...
Okay, what's the front line?
If someone brings something to him, Pac's going to address it there and then.
Edin.
If Pac turned up to Houston, Pac would have walked out there because he's certified like that.
We don't know that.
Nah.
We don't know that, though.
Fam.
We don't know that.
Fam.
We don't know that.
Fam.
How are you so certain that Tupac?
You know what?
Two mandem is gonna go walk on stage.
You know how I know? Because people say he's arrogant, but he will back his talk.
Hey, you know what?
Pat got shot how many times? Yeah, 5 times. Yeah,
yeah.
And he still come with a mouth because he could, because he knows, like, yo, you shot me and I'm not dead. Yeah, I will still come for you.
But Tupac didn't go out to get shot.
But it still
he was actually pretty upset that he got shot 5 times.
But the fact is, he was still came with the mouth.
Yeah, but
and that is no,
that's a different point.
That's backing up.
That's what I just said. I want to see Takeshi hold some taunts, even get shot, but I don't want to see him get killed because I want to see because it's talking the talk. You get me? So eventually, like everyone's saying, when it comes, it comes. I want to see what his what energy is on after that. Because he might be on that Pac vibe after. What, and I'll be having a different comment. If Takeshi 6ix9ine gets shot 5 times now,
making it.
You don't know that.
Not with them moves. Them hairy moves.
If Takeshi 6ix9ine gets shot 5 times and survives.
Them hairy moves ain't stopping nothing.
I want to see what energy is on afterwards. And it backs his talk after. Are we having a different conversation? Are we calling him a gangster? Are we calling him a thug life like we would with Pac? What's the difference with Takeshi 6ix9ine and Pac?
Should I tell you what the difference is?
What?
That, number one, if he actually backed his talk and walked out on that stage, yeah?
We don't know.
All right, then, that's certified. That is certified because you've backed your talk. That's like me saying, yeah? That's like me saying, yeah, I can beat anybody in the world on stage, anybody. And then I get to a show and, I don't know, Philip is there, Mr. Olympia's there, and I get to the door and it's like, oh, well, I think I better go home because the oven's on. I think I left something on. I better get home. Come on. Behave.
Fam, you got to be smart. I'm like, you know, maybe Tupac would have went out there, but it's not smart.
But it
would have been smart. It wouldn't have been smart.
But would that build his credibility?
What the hell's credibility?
Because that's what you're making when you're talking the talk. Don't talk the talk if you ain't going to walk the walk. I don't
confess. You know what?
That's the thing, you know. I don't see this like, yo, I'm a bad man. I'm this, I'm that. Because I'm not that guy. You get me? I'm all about positivity, bundling negativity. But...
So you like the clout?
But... No, I'm positive. I'm actually a positive person.
No, but I'm saying you want Takeshi to earn his clout.
If you talk the talk, you got to walk the walk, or else you. And that's another reason why a lot of the guys you're not backing your talk. Mm. If you did it and you walked out on stage, everyone would be like, all right, cool. You worked out. If he got tomped up out there, I'd say, you know what? At least you even backed your talk. I'll rate you for that.
But if you know you're going to get boxed, if you know you're, what's the word? You got less man. You're under whatever.
What's outnumbered.
Yeah, frankly.
Like it's an ambush.
You know you're out. You know you're outnumbered. You know you're going to get ambushed. Mm. Would you walk into it?
If I came with the talk, I would.
Nah, man, it don't make sense to walk into an ambush. So what? Nobody ever in the whole world walks into an ambush. Nobody, who has ever walked into an ambush?
I could get deep on
that. Nobody ever walks into an ambush.
I could say something, but anyway.
Nobody ever walks into an ambush.
But that's not the point.
What? That is the point?
No, my point is, yeah, if you talk the talk, you have to back it or your credibility shrinks with me.
So...
If you say you pull up anywhere, you will pull up, you'll walk out. If a man wants to bring beef to you, you deal with it there and then.
I don't...
How do we know that Jay Prince would have attacked him on stage? Something would have happened on stage. How do we know?
He was saying it to the crowd. Yeah. Where's the kitchen?
Yeah, but how do you know?
You don't know.
He might have just been talk. If he did that, came out, what? If it's all those people, they have a scuffle, they break it up. Obviously, he's not going to shoot him, because if he shot him, it'd be pretty dumb. Because I've like, how many thousands of witnesses? So, if he got clapped on stage, yeah, he's going to get up and walk away from it.
All right, then. Random question. So, who do you think would have walked into the ambush?
Pac would have walked out. Because he's certified like that. And
How do we know that Pac certified like that?
Why?
Yeah.
Because the reason why I say that is because he backed his talk.
When?
When he got sprayed.
He backed his talk after that, when?
When no, the fact that he backed his talk because in one thing in this hip hop thing, one I've noticed, yeah, there's a lot of actors.
Mm.
Yeah. Now even if one man becomes an artist, yeah, and comes with a gangster talk, and then he gets like, you know, he gets shot or whatever, and if they just quiver away, yeah, people say, okay, then you didn't back the talk. But if you keep coming back, and you're still on the same vibe, yeah, and you may still deal with stuff in the streets yourself, then fair enough. It's like, you know what it's like, It's like, yeah, you remember when we used to hear of the Lox?
Yeah.
when they used to come with all the moving white talk, yeah?
Yeah.
And then one of them get locked up for a little while, every once in a while, yeah? That's back in the talk, bruv! That is okay, back in the talk.
Okay.
And the thing is, you know the reason why I say that is because as well, this isn't like, if I had beef with Spock, yeah, not that Spock's the guy to be beefing with,
no.
But, and I'm talking to Spock X this and this, yeah. Then, I get it. Like the beef's most likely gonna happen,
yeah.
And if something happens, we deal with it after. That's how the mentality is of the streets. Yeah. But this guy is like calling out the whole of the West Coast. Yeah. Fair enough, nothing's happened to him yet. And really, why does he... I don't see the point. I don't know why. I don't get it. Brilliant. He sits there and says, I'll pull up anywhere in LA. And he says, and then he says, the LA fans, I got love for you.
No, okay.
How does that even make sense? How does that even make sense?
You know what? Because you don't like him. So.
And he's a knob.
Because you don't like him. Let's go back. Why did he say that he can pull up anywhere? How did that situation even start?
I don't know, you know, fully.
It started from them?
From Jay Prince?
No, not even Houston. Like, the LA situation now.
The LA situation.
So obviously he said, yo, I'm going to be out in LA. And then they would post him videos saying, oh, nah, you can't come here. Yeah. And he's like, yo, fam, I'm putting up whatever I want. You get me? Like,
even so, I don't care.
You got to respect that.
No, but the fact is as well, is that it's all his talk. I saw, I was looking at a picture from Snoop's son. I think his oldest son. And he posted a picture of Tekashi and it was like, yo, don't get trapped onto this hype. You get me? Because it's just negativity and he's bringing it over to the West Coast. And that's why I can't stand him. It's like,
you know,
if someone literally, before any of this started, said, you're this, and I don't like this and I don't like that, I'd understand. But why are you trying to make beef?
It's not making beef.
Why are you trying to cause a disturbance?
It's just to create
more attention to yourself.
But he hasn't started any beef. He hasn't started anything. And you know what? I feel like the reason why I'm kind of harping on the Tupac situation, because I feel like I said, Tekashi 6ix9ine is a true reflection of this generation. If Tekashi 6ix9ine was about in 95, 94, whenever, we wouldn't even have all these videos that he's posting. We wouldn't have all this talk that we're seeing, these interviews so frequently, academics on his dick, you get me? Like, that wouldn't be happening back then. So maybe if Tekashi 6ix9ine was around back in 1994...
It would have lasted 6 months.
How do we know?
Someone would have snuffed.
But that's what I'm saying, like, Tupac in this day and age?
Someone would have snuffed.
It might be just like how Tekashi 6ix9ine is now.
Nah.
We don't know.
No.
We don't know.
I don't want to talk about this punk anymore.
Yeah, and this went on for a lot longer than...
absolute tool.
This went on for a lot longer than... But...
And I'm going to start about... I'm going to go there.
Okay,
I don't want to talk about it no more. I never, ever, 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 ever want to talk about that punk again.
I think I've said all my points anyway.
The platform to talk about him.
Well, no, but just one last question, man. just to put a full,
I'm not gonna respond.
A full stop on it. One last blanket statement. Why don't you like Tekashi 6ix9ine?
Because he's a knob.
That's not even an answer. Yeah. All right. Cool.
Let's move on.
You know, you
trying to turn my energy. You know, man, trying to change my mood. You know,
you woke you up, though.
I'm just positive vibes. I'm positive vibes, bro.
Alright, last week you wanted to talk about Yachty, that interview that
it's
did.
Weird,
you know,
man.
I went to watch it, but
I didn't watch all of it. I didn't get to all of it.
No, I didn't get to the part that you mentioned.
It's weird, man.
You said something about he mentioned the money.
Yeah, that's like music. Yeah, what is music? It's expression. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but at the end of the day, I look at it and look at hip hop and R&B, and it's also, it kind of like, what's the word? Perpetuates the culture, keeps it going. It like breathes life into it. It kind of like can inspire you. And it's sad, in my opinion, that some guys are just making money. It's like, yeah, but I'm rich. Yeah, but you've got more than, you've got a responsibility to talk to all the kids that, you know, are out there trying. It's like, some, don't get me wrong, yeah. in our day, gangster rap was just gangster rap, yeah? Mm-hmm. But you had your artists that were big that still, you know, they actually were bothered.
Mm.
Were more than... It's a point of being just... It's not. It's a point of being more than the music, more than just money.
All right, give me... Sorry, give me an example of what artist was big and bothered, like you just said.
In terms of... what? In terms of rap?
Yeah, yeah.
There's loads, to be fair. Kendrick, for example.
Oh.
I mean...
Okay. I mean, how... I thought he was going back even more than that.
Oh, you want to go back?
Well, I thought you was going back even more.
Common.
Alright, I see. You. Okay, yeah. I get what you're saying, but they've always been the anomaly. I'm shit with words today. They've always been the. There's not many of them. The Kendricks, the Commons, Talib Kweli, and them, and there's never been many of them anywhere.
But
so we can't compare.
But you know what it is as well. But you know what it is. It's like it kind of like says to me that they only make music for the money, and really should be doing it for the love, man.
Mm.
Doing it for the love, and it's not about like just get stacking peas and just bouncing, because what you're doing is going to be played for like you don't know. At the end of the day, the way I see it is that even Migos, it's like. They spoken about where they're from. Quavo's out there giving money to schools, giving money out to his old high school, his old high school basketball team and X, Y, and Z, And that's positive, you get me?
Mm.
He's using his platform to say, yo, I'm helping the people where I'm from. You know what I mean? And that's one thing, I've never disliked Migos.
Mm.
I like them. I do like them. And I've never knocked them, but... It's a situation, he's using his platform and he's using his message to say, yo, I'm helping my peoples.
Yeah.
You get me? And it's not just about the money. It's not just about the money, because at the end of the day, if you say it's just about the money, you ain't bothered about me. So why should I buy your album?
You know what, though? That's true. A lot of people say that. But, okay, Yacht is a bit younger than Migos. Yacht is, I think he just turned 20 or something like that. Mm. So...
But even... How's Jaden Smith?
Yeah, Jaden Smith what? 19, 20, so I don't know.
Even he's got more positivity in him.
Yeah. But I mean, everyone's different.
Interviews that he talk a lot of positive things, you know what I mean?
But, okay, well, we can't really say Jaden, because Jaden's always known money. Someone like Yachty, he always...
Did I hear that?
Yachty says, like,
even so,
he was broken in his dorm room and then he got rich and now he's just... Money's in his life and he's abusing it or...
But what happens, when the money's not enough then? What happens then? When you get bored of the money, what are you going to do?
I don't think... when you was 20, was you really thinking that?
Me?
Okay, was you thinking that? When you was 20, thinking, if I got rich tomorrow, I'd be... Like, I don't know what the question is, but...
To be fair, even I was 20, I'm not going to lie, when I was 20... But, see, that's what I'm saying. It's different because I'm a deep guy. You know what I mean?
I hope it's recorded.
But it's like at the end of the day, from my upbringing, it's a case that if I gain, I'm supposed to help somebody else. I'm supposed to help my young brother that's coming up, because
I mean, I'm sure he's probably helping his circle out.
Yeah, but even so, you got to be wider than that.
Yeah,
even from his first album, he made enough money to help his circle. Good, very well. Yeah. Now you're on his second album now.
Yeah.
Now if you're on your second album, it should be more than just the money. It should be, because you've grown bigger than that now. Realistically, now people might say, yeah, but you're putting too much pressure on him. I understand that, but with the way that the music industry is now and the way that the money can come in from streams and whatever, the money is it's easier, to be honest, to be bigger. Yeah. Because
this is the reason why
when people compare themselves to guys in the past in terms of numbers, I don't really buy it, because when you see when Nicki come out with that statement, I sold more than Aretha, I'm like, yo, you've got no right saying that.
Yeah.
Because when Aretha was making music, they didn't want black people to come to certain shops.
Yeah, that too.
You get me? So how can you come out there and say to me, oh, I'm bigger than Aretha? No, you're not. Because you, I can come out here, open my phone within the comfort of my own home and buy your album. Whereas when Aretha Franklin was making music, I couldn't go to that shop because it's said no blacks allowed.
Yeah.
You get me? And also, I would have to take myself, leave my yard, get up, go on a bus, go on a car, and go to the shop. That's a lot more effort than going there and moving my thumb about 20 times.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
All right. But to bring it back to the money conversation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ed was vexing, ain't it?
I'm on one today, you know. Yo, it's them low carbs, you know. On it.
Yeah, all right. To go back to the money situation, the conversation then. With Yachty as well.
Yeah.
Remember when... The Everyday Struggle, the legendary one now.
With Joe nearly busting blood vessels in his head.
No, but the thing is, Joe had so many points in that Yachty didn't latch onto, it seems. So basically, the whole thing was Joe was saying, yo, look, Yachty's saying, yo, I'm happy, I'm making music. I was broke before, I'm happy now. And Joe's like, yo, basically what he was saying, without the shouting, he was saying, yo, look, I've been your age. I had my hit and got big and got a lot of money. You have to. I've seen a lot of people do that. You have to be smart. You have to. Mm. You have to be doing it for more than money.
Yeah.
You know what I mean. But Yachty just wasn't listening. Everyone's different, so maybe Yachty is one of those people that don't listen. But.
But the thing is, you know what it is. The way I see it is that if you don't have substance and you don't have character as a person, you will always have something lacking and you will try to find something to fill it.
Mm.
And that's just in life. But yeah. Some people might see that as family, some might people that as a sport, as a hobby, as something. Some people use it as drugs, sex, and money. Yeah. Jeez. They think that, or cheese. And then some people, it's like once you get enough of that thing, then they'll be like, yo, I need something more than this.
Yeah. But hip hop has always been materialistic. And it's like, okay, think back in the day now, say random numbers. Say the 90s, it was 20% materialistic. Mm. The next generation comes, they're going to latch onto materialistic because everyone wants to be rich.
Yeah.
Or a lot of people want to be rich, you know what I mean? So the 2000s would probably say 50% materialistic.
Yeah.
Right now, it's probably about 80% materialistic.
80%, yeah.
But obviously, the kids are just hearing it and latching onto the materialism side of it because not... Only is it coming from hip-hop, but it's also amplified by, like, social media, everyone posting cards and that. It's going to get worse.
The way that music's changed in terms of the 90s, pardon me, the 90s, we talk about the streets.
Mm.
So, Jamal, that was on the block, could listen to Biggie, Pop, Lox, and relate to what they're speaking to.
Yeah.
Then the Puff era came in. Shiny suits, whatever. Dancing around. Bentleys. Chains, whatever. Women. But you still had those records on the album that were still gritty.
Yeah.
Then, so the 2000s came. A bit more upmarket, whatever. Mm. However... The music still had the street orientation until you got to people more like, say, Missy and Timbo, where they made it about the sound.
Yeah.
So it was different. It wasn't alternative, but it was just different because they hit a different angle. Now, fast forward to now, the music, some of these guys, I find that the kids, they can't. Yes, they like partying. Yeah, they do.
Mm.
They like, you know, turning up. But in terms of relating to them, they can't because...
Who can't relate to them?
Some of the kids. They won't be able to because what they're talking about, like... I'm talking about, like, a 10-year-old on a block.
Mm.
He ain't gonna relate to Yachty.
But could
I know I shouldn't be listening to rap music, by the way, before any parents sit there and say, well, you shouldn't be playing this music. I get it, but, yo, you know what I mean.
But then could we relate to Mandem back in the day? The rappers back in the day?
Struggle.
Okay, I know what you're saying now. So you're saying basically there's no B side of it. There's no... Yeah. Okay, so Jay-Z had his struggle, but then it had the glitz and glamour as well. You're saying, with Yachty, it's all... Yeah, I know what you're saying.
But also, I find that it's weird, man. It's weird because I know we're going to get into it in a bit, but I was listening to that Triple X album.
Yeah.
And
are you listening to the new one?
I listened to a bit of it. I listened to a few tracks.
Yeah.
Yo, that's, do you know that tune Sad? There's one tune and it calls Sad. Don't play it. Please don't play it. Don't play it. Don't play it. Don't play it.
Don't play it.
Don't play it. Don't play it. Juice, don't play it.
Yeah, I just need to know which one it
don't
is.
Don't play the tune.
Wait.
Because, I'm driving in the car and I press the tune Sad. Oh, my days. I never felt so depressed in my life.
Yeah, I like that song.
I'm driving. After 30 seconds, I'm like, yo, I feel sad, you know? I feel sad.
You know, let me piggyback on what you just said, yeah. So, like you just said, back in the day, you had the grit, the street, and then you had the money side or whatever. So now, think about it. People ain't on the street no more, you know.
But they are, bruv.
Who's on the street?
Mandem.
Mandem ain't on the street now.
Fam. No. Hear this. This is another reason why, as well, I think that American music has disconnected with the UK.
Yeah.
Because if you listen to, I don't know, the majority of UK artists, we can still relate. Why? That's why people say, because even Americans say that UK music is 15 years behind America.
Mm.
And that's why a lot of the UK music is hitting, because we relate to it.
Yeah.
And even the American guys, the older American generation, like my age, not saying I'm old, but you know what I mean? But they can relate to the UK artists because what they're saying is relatable. They're on the block, yeah?
Who's on the block? No one's on the block, you know.
Man on the block, fam.
Who's on the block? What end? Whatever you're driving for, you see man on the block. No one's on the block, you know.
Fam, do you hear what happens in London every week?
But man ain't on the block. That's different.
Fam.
Let me land.
A whole lot of grease is still going on in London.
Let me land.
Go on.
So, Mandem ain't on the street no more, you know. They're not on the street. They're doing road.
Still doing bits.
Man, everyone's in their yard or in the trap house.
But that's still...
No, that's what I'm saying.
In the trap house, that still counts, bro.
They're doing road. So, what? Okay, let me land. Let me get to
the point. So, you're saying... Just because they're not on the block, literally standing outside their house.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, but it's still together. They're still together. And it's still the same thing.
Okay, let me go to my point. Okay, so back in the day, a lot of us, I've never been a road guy.
Yeah.
But I was out on the road.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I was hanging around.
I get that.
I was either playing Kirby or knock-door run.
Big up, man, you know about Kirby still.
I do knock-door run, you get me? Yeah, but like, I was on the road.
Yeah.
You get me? I wasn't doing road, but whatever. Now, at the moment, if you're on the road, you're doing road. There's no one out there playing Kirby anymore. No one's playing Tracker, Naked, Nakadora.
Yo! Wait. I need to do something. I need to see if he's going to answer the phone. Yo, wait there. This is mad, you know. This is really funny.
Do you want an aux?
Yeah, I need an aux. Yeah, give me the aux, yeah. Give me the aux. Let me see if he answers the phone.
I don't even know he's calling.
Yeah. Let me see if he answers the phone.
Is it in?
Right there.
The aux in?
Should be in. It's not in.
Oh, what's it? Now you're going on loudspeaker?
I'll just put it on loudspeaker. Oh, it's got to go through.
Yeah.
Nah, man, needs to answer the phone, man. Answer the phone.
Yeah.
Yo, fam.
Yeah.
You live on the podcast?
Huh?
You live on the podcast?
Hey,
who is it?
Yo, it's Adam.
Well gone, Adam. Long time.
Juice just said he played Nike.
Yeah. What my name is?
Nah, basically, Adam told me about this game, Nike, and I was like, fam, I've never played this old game called Nike. It just sounds like,
the name's mad.
It sounds like, some game that had some inappropriate touching.
See, Nakey never had no touching.
Tracker. Did not make up that game. Bless up, Juice.
Yeah, man. With Tracker, with Tracker, you had to touch a man in it, and like Tracker, 1, 2, 3 or whatever it was. With Nakey, you just had to see a man.
What?
It's basically if you're.
You have to what?
Just see a man in it. You didn't have to touch him.
I can't hear you.
Oh.
He said, you have to see them, not touch them.
I can't remember how to play. Yeah. I was not a player at Pro.
Tracker was like tag, but you had to hold onto a man and say, tracker, 1, 2, 3. With Nakey, man could be hiding in the bush. I'm like, yo, is that Adrian? I run back to base and then say, Nakey, 1, 2, 3.
So basically, you have to see them just to like.
Yeah, you have to see them and then run back to base. But if I see you hiding behind the bush,
yeah.
And then you see me, and then you get to the base before me.
You, yeah.
Yeah, but Chaka, I had to touch you and say, you know what I mean?
Man thought I was falling.
These times, yeah, I thought Adam was playing some bedroom games.
Naked, look. It's mad. The name is mad, though. Yo. The name is mad. So
all them people out there know about Naked, big up yourselves. Yo, fam, I'll call you later. Yeah, bless up.
Bless.
Big up. You never heard of Naked?
Yeah, when my man told me that, I was like, bam. I don't know what kind of gear you have. Yo, some bare allegations. Come from that game. But yeah, carry on.
Yeah, so so back in the day, people were outside.
Yeah.
Now, if you're outside, you're doing road, it seems. And then if you're inside, you're just not doing road. So what's happened now? It seems like obviously you still got the money rap and then you've got the road rap here and there, but now you've got this new emo rap.
What?
Emo rap, man, sad rap. XXXTentacion. These man that probably would have been on the streets playing Naked, but now they're sitting at home sad because their friends are all on Facebook and don't want to come out. No, it's a real thing,
I know I shouldn't laugh.
That's what it is like.
Yo, that's deep, you know.
The kids are sad. Kids are depressed now, you know.
That's mad.
Back in the day when you was playing Kirby and football against the garage and squash or whatever, you wasn't really sad because you was out. You're probably bored on the ends, but now kids are sad because they're in the house and no one comes out the house.
That's deep, you know.
You know what I mean?
That is deep.
People don't come out the house now, so now you got this new sad rap with all these guys that are sad.
Yo, all
and
I know.
There's a market for
after 30 seconds, yeah, I was just considering my life. You know what I mean?
Exercise.
I was in a bad place. So I was like, yo, let me switch up this tune, man. Come off this. Next star. Press that. And it was all right. It's a bit better.
Yeah. So there's a new I didn't even get the we're talking about relating to artists. Yeah. So there's a new layer now of relatability.
I can understand where it's come from, that part.
Mm-hmm.
But Yachty and XXX is two different kind of teams.
Yeah, you know what I mean.
But the way I see Yachty, it's just like, yo, bruv.
But what I'm saying, there's always been that in hip hop.
I get that. There's always been that guy that's just
money.
About money. Himself.
Yeah.
But you look at it and you just think, yo, it kind of like just like
it
spreads the greed vibe, and I hate greed.
Yeah, it's sad because and with these guys, like Lil Yachty, probably one of the worst rappers ever. I'll say top five worst rappers ever. You know what I mean? He puts the money ahead of the art almost.
Yes.
Because, like, he's not good at music and all he's talking about is money and bitches or whatever. You know what I mean? It's like, it's all good when you're talking about money and your music's good as well. Like, say Lil Wayne, you talk a lot about money, but his music was actually really, really good and artistic. But, like, yeah, he ain't got that. And there's a few other guys that ain't got that because they're just copying and trying to get on. Everyone's just trying to get on. Everyone's trying to get on, and it's like this day and age now, social media, when it's so easy to get on. Mm. Everyone's just trying to get on. There's no originality. There's not much art about it now.
It's weird, man. I was a bit saddened because I'm like, yo, is this where rap music is headed?
Yeah.
Because realistically, when you've got the old school guys, when they're finished, you're gonna be left with this.
Mm-hmm.
Where's the art gonna go?
Perfect segue for me now, because I ain't gonna lie, that XXXTentacion album, him, is amazing. You know,
he's got ability.
He's amazing.
I'm not gonna lie,
like
he's a bit strange, but yo,
I'm not gonna hold that against him. Though he's a strange guy.
I sit there and I listen to some. It's like the tune with Joey Badass,
and I'm like, yo, you got that part. You know, I wanted to play that.
The kid can spit, you know, and I rate his ability.
Is it up?
Just don't play too much, you know, because we don't need this pull down.
To be honest, XXX should have love for SoundCloud. He's a SoundCloud artist. He's always releasing songs on SoundCloud. Why not you saying? Let me just. Cheers.
Good, man.
But yeah, man, you know, like I said, I still hold a bit of faith for these new school artists when they hear, man, like XXXTentacion. I'm not going to let his image and how he looks and how he acts online.
His actual ability.
When it comes to music, and you can tell he wants to put art in his music. Like, that's just one song. He can rap, but there's rock tunes on the album. Yeah, if you're into that, you get me. There's the emo songs.
I had to skip a couple of tunes still.
Yeah.
I was like, yo, fam, that's not my lane, you know. Yeah. That's not my lane.
The emo tingy does it well. The intro is just talking, like, you know what I mean? He puts a lot into his music, and it's obviously Kendrick feels him. Like, there's mandem in the industry that feel him. You know what I mean? He was on the show, Joey Badass. You get me? Like, when you see them kind of collaborations there, he's obviously getting acknowledgement from other spitters, you get me? So, man know about XXXTentacion, and it gives me hope for the newer artists, just to know that there's man out there that's still putting what seems like they're all into music, you get me? So when you see man like Yachty, who I got no time for Yachty, I got zero time for Lil Yachty. To be honest, I got a headache, and I was actually enraged listening to Yachty's album. Like, now I got angry, you know. I got angry. You know what I got angry about? Because obviously, we did a podcast in it, so like, I listen to music, but I don't usually try and listen to albums all the way through if I don't like it. But I was like, oh, this shit, man. But I had to stick it out to the end. I was like, oh, next tune. Oh, this is horrible. Like, I stuck it out to the end, man. I think it was like 47 minutes or something.
What a bun now.
Yeah, no, it hurts still when I was vexed, but had to be done. Just to give you a review. One star.
One star.
Yeah.
And half a mic.
Yeah, it could have got 0 stars. I mean, sorry, there is 0 stars. Like, it's not the bottom. Because it wasn't... Some of the beats were right still. But nah, his ability is terrible. And when he sings or does that little singing, whatever it's called nowadays, it's not too bad. But when he's rapping, horrible.
Shocking.
Yeah. Oh, with XXXTentacion as well. Do you listen to all the album?
I've listened to all of it. I listened to a few tracks.
Why does he only make 2-minute songs?
I don't know. I sat there and I was like, yo, how long is this whole thing?
Yeah.
It's 38 minutes. I'm like, 18... how has he squeezed 18 songs in 38 minutes?
Exactly.
How? Sitting there thinking, that is not like... What?
Yeah, that's...
Because that's... I'm like, yo, a normal track average lasts about... three and a half minutes to just under 4, and I'm like, and you've made 18 in 38.
Yeah, because it's like his songs are like chorus, verse, chorus, outro. You get me? And it's like, huh? And it's like, I want him to push the ball out, man, just switch them, because it's almost as if like he finds a melody, latches onto that melody, rides it through the song, and then done. But I want to just switch the melody, make the beat break down a bit, or just push the ball out a bit. To be honest, I'd love to see, you never know, maybe it would happen. I'd love to see XXX and Kanye collaboration.
That'd be good still.
Just because...
It'd be very, very, it'd be different.
Yeah.
The range of it would be, like, mad. Ridiculous. Yeah. Ridiculous.
But, yeah, man. Yo, how far are we into that? 1 hour.
It's all right.
Yeah, man.
We got time.
You
know,
we still got DGCs as well. Yeah. Because I ain't gonna lie, it's been a quiet week, so I didn't think we're gonna have too much to talk about still.
But to be honest, you know what? Sometimes I like a quiet week. I don't need too much stuff going on. It's been a hard week at work.
Yeah, it's been horrible. It's been a horrible week at work. I don't, you know, it's Saturday. I don't want to talk about work. Let's not. I'm not even. So, yeah, let's jump into the DGCs still. I'm gonna save some topics for next episode.
Got playlists as well.
Yeah.
You're gonna talk about Bobby Tarantino. So listen to a couple of tunes off there, you know.
Well, that's another thing I was kind of gonna save still.
You wanna give it? We'll give that next week just because.
You know, well, you wanna actually?
No. I want it fully.
Yeah, cause I listen to it fully.
I wanna let it marinate for a week. It takes me a week to fully marinate music.
All right.
Let's go.
Come here, let me just sing it.
Did you see what I done? Came in a black Benz, left in the white one.
Okay.
So. You want to start?
I ain't got nothing. I didn't see nothing this week. Actually, let me just quickly say this. I seen a post, it says 2 Chainz now owns all his masters. But then I said, I Googled it. I didn't find nothing.
That was a lie.
But it's just like, it's in Beef Alert posted. I don't know if you follow Beef Alert. But Beef Alert posted it. And I ain't seen nothing since. Mm. So I wanted to find something to talk about the topic. But if there's no information out there about this, I just have to say congratulations to T-Trains. If it's true, hopefully it is.
Hopefully it is, man.
Because T-Trains, one of my favourite rappers, you know.
He's good, man.
Yeah, it's slowly... like busting the game right now. It's like it's always going hard.
What do you think of this Facebook thing? Everyone saying delete your Facebook.
Yeah, did you see when I posted on Facebook?
I didn't see you know.
You know what it is? What do you think about it?
I think that these corporations...
Alright, well, let's explain what happened for people that don't know.
What did they have?
I don't even know what happened.
I read that more than 50... This is what I read. More than 50 million Facebook profiles were hacked to help Trump gain votes in the presidential election.
Oh, there's that too.
This was part two. And then it says, Facebook's value has dropped 50 million. Investors are suing Mark Zuckerberg to... he actually spoke about it in the week, yeah. Mm. And they're using basically your information to make adverts in it to advertise to you.
Well, I think that's always been the case. But I think what it's been doing is actually Facebook have been selling
your information,
listening into conversations, like looking at conversations between me and you, and like targeting from what we're saying.
Yeah.
And people have always said like, "Yeah, I'm sure I was just talking about that."
That's what I'm saying. And the thing is, yeah, I'm looking at certain things that. There's certain things that you will just speak about. Mm. You don't search for it on the internet and it just pops up and you're like, yo, well, go on.
Mm.
So, but the thing is, in my opinion, they're all in on it. What? Samsung, Apple, yeah. Everyone with a smartphone. Yo, this costs smart for a reason, you know.
Well, here's the thing. Like, selling information is out there. People know that happens. And when you read terms... Well, when people don't read terms and agreements, but apparently it's in there to say that... what you post you don't own and that kind of stuff. And Facebook can use your information for third party companies and that kind of stuff. So they do sell your information, they sell your, you know, your character profile. So you know what I mean, black guy, whatever.
Mm.
But then invading privacy, listening and conversations and reading conversation, that's a whole nother thing. But then my view on that is, to be honest, what has made us put so much trust in these corporations anyway?
It's true.
Like, why do we really trust that these billionaires are not going to read our conversations?
Don't get me wrong, I know my conversations are fire, but yeah. Get me? It's like, oh my goodness.
Yeah, so it's like, why did we think any better of them?
Nah.
And why are we deleting Facebook now?
They've been doing it for years.
Yeah, if you really, I got
for years.
Regions that are like, nah, bro, nah, I'm off the grid, right? I'm conspiracy theorist guys. I'm like, all right, bloody hell, delete your Facebook, innit? Delete your Instagram, delete your whatever. You can't have these accounts and claim to be anti-government and against establishment and low-key. Like,
the way I see it is that, number one, if the feds want to find you, they will find you.
Yeah, if your phone tracks your location.
That's the first thing.
Sorry.
Your phone, and that's another thing as well, I've noticed on my phone, you know, when you turn off your location, there are certain apps, that are designed to put it on always.
Or else the app
won't work.
Yeah.
That's the first thing. Second thing is that, realistically, the feds, if they want to find out something, they will.
Mm.
They will.
Mm.
They can invade every single piece of privacy that you have, apart from staring into your bedroom window. Yeah? And even some of them might do that. And because of that, I think... there's only so much they can do. What are they going to do with your information? If they steal money from you, I'll get it.
Well, they're selling it to advertisers, isn't it?
But then you don't have to buy it.
Oh, yeah, you know, but Facebook get paid.
I know they get paid because they do.
You know what I mean, so they're basically selling you, isn't
it? It's weird, man. Yeah. It's weird.
All I say is, fam, if you're really serious about deleting your Facebook,
delete everything.
Delete your Instagram and WhatsApp as well, because Facebook owns those as well. And then you might as well not have a smartphone. You might as well go buy a £10 Nokia from Argos.
It's true.
What else can you do? Don't walk around town, because CCTV is everywhere. Yep. If you really want to, you can't exist in this day and age, 2018, and not expect people not to be watching. Like, yeah, they're watching.
Big Brother's watching,
they're,
man.
They're watching.
They're always, they're constantly watching.
I mean, what I said, the best thing to do is just live a good life. And then don't be like, let them watch. Like, I don't care. You're going to watch me. Like, you can watch me. I ain't doing nothing. Sure. You get me? Like, I ain't doing nothing.
I'm not tired.
You get me? Like, you want to watch me. You want to read my combo. If I read my combo, you get me? Like,
I ain't saying nothing. None of them, what are they called? Them words that alert them.
Oh, you know what I registered to be?
What?
I don't know if I can say
No, don't say it, because anyhow, yeah, we get shut down because of one word. Yeah.
Nah, I'll say it still. I registered to me. It said, yo, when you sign up to the army, yeah?
Yeah.
They will pull up your search history.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they will pull up.
I bet they don't want, you don't want to find yours yet.
this is what we're talking about. It's they pull up what you've been searching on porn. And they said, and it was saying basically that it means something, like it's the type of porn that you watch means something about you.
What?
Yeah, I mean, this psychologist probably on hand, okay, to say, oh, you like, I mean, to be honest, yeah.
I told you stop searching them midgets, man.
Oh, You funny.
Sorry, you know, dwarfs. Sorry.
Can I go in? Oh, no, yeah, for real. Yeah,
my bad.
Sorry, dwarfs. Sorry. Fam. I ain't even gonna go into it now, forget it.
It's because he said he must have put in on Pornhub Lord of the Rings.
Nah. I don't even know what that means. Like, what is that joke?
Short people in it?
I've never watched Lord of the Rings.
You never seen Lord of the Rings?
Nah.
Words.
It's like 3 hours and no black people, man. Set in medieval times. That film did not want me to watch it. That's all I know. Yeah, I ain't even gonna say what I was gonna say still.
What was another one? Did you see that woman?
Oh,
it sounds bad. I know it sounds bad. Yeah, this is bad. Did you see that woman? She was 68, yeah. And she ran over that woman, this one next woman, yeah, because she accidentally, I think it was London, she accidentally put her foot. First of all, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Two-way traffic, yeah?
Yeah.
Two-way traffic. She overtakes the car in front, and there's a bus in front, yeah? Mm. So she's gone whoop, boom, into there. Take into consideration, 68. And instead of putting her foot on the brake, she put her foot on the accelerator. Boom. She comes off the road, onto the pavement, and ran over one woman.
She died?
Woman died.
Oh, I'm upset, though.
You get me? The woman died, and she only got 24 months in prison.
Yeah, behind the wheel, you don't really...
That's mad.
It's mad, isn't it? It's a bit weird.
It is mad. And basically, a woman should have been wearing her glasses and she wasn't wearing them. Mm-hmm. She made a mistake. And it's weird, yeah. No offense, but I know she was white. I know she was real white because, one, they didn't put no picture. They put her name in. Mm. And the way they played it is like, this is a Daily Mail, them pagans. And when they said it was something about she has five amazing children, 10 grandchildren who all own their own business. She's a really successful person. Yet, those are the same people that are sitting there trying to cuss out Wiley and calling them drug dealers and all this for accepting something good. It's weird how they play it.
Yeah, I mean, what's the beef here, Daily Mail or the woman?
I'm thinking about the woman, yo. It's mad. Yo, someone's dead, yeah, and you only get 24 months.
But that's a lot, though. Like, if you drive it and kill someone, the time's reduced. Like,
so why do people go to jail? Yeah. Not that I'm selling drugs.
Yeah.
Why do people go to jail for 15, 20 years for moving some weight?
Because you're not paying tax.
So that exactly. That is, fam, so basically, money's more worth than life.
You know, human life has no value to the government. There's no value on human life. Like, if you're doing fraud, you will get a long sentence because you're stealing from the government. That's how they see it.
That's
if you're not paying tax, you're stealing from the government. Queen. Huh? Oh, is it from the Queen directly? That's how they pull it. That's you're stealing from the Queen, from the monarchy. You get me? But, okay, to go to the woman now, to go to the driver, you know what? See, I'm you know, I hate, and I don't hate much, but I hate driving on the road with old people. And okay, it's a bit weird though because 68 ain't really it's old good, like that. But the way I see it is, yeah, when you hit like 60 or something,
should do a test again.
Yeah, you have to do a retest or something in it because, fam, a lot of these old people.
A different place, man.
A lot of these old people on the road now, yeah, are driving terrible. terrible driving. And the thing is, I used to get like vexed back in the day about it. I used to get vexed. Now I get kind of like scared because I honestly feel like, yeah, if I was, I'm a good driver. I'm not even big in my head. I'm a good driver. I feel like if I was to get into an accident, it might be some old person behind the wheel to nearly kill me or kill me. You get me? And that kind of scares me now because it's like, it's just, this shouldn't, not that it shouldn't be on the road.
Have you seen that show with the driving test, that where the people are 90?
Nah.
Yeah, there's a TV show, still wifey watches it, where most of the people on the show, they're like 90 and above.
Yeah.
And a lot of them pass the test still. Obviously, some of them like run red lights and all that, but a lot of them are decent.
Yeah, some of the things you see, I see them doing.
No, because there's a lot of drivers that are over 60 and they are actually good drivers.
Yeah, now I'm not even saying 60 because I know my grandma still drives good still and she's 70 plus.
It's weird, it's just
a mad thing. Sometimes you see them on the road. And you know what? Actually, you know, if I'm being totally serious here, just thinking about it, I haven't really seen an old person do anything bad behind the wheel.
No.
But you know when you're trying to drive quick and they're driving slow and it's like, yo,
you know what?
And then you're overtaking them, look like that, like they're just struggling behind the wheel.
What happens, I've never actually seen them do too much. When I'm driving and someone's driving slow in front of me, I'm like, yo, you better be old.
Yeah.
If you're not old, you know, I'm gonna give you the death stare. Yeah? I know. I was gonna say that.
What the hell is this?
Yeah, it was in America, Arizona, where the Uber,
is that the driverless Uber?
Yeah.
They got video footage of it.
Must have cameras. All of them.
I mean, they released it.
It's down to Uber. It's releasing the camera footage. We're watching the video right now.
So basically, the
Uber, like just
the Uber with no driver.
With no driver.
Hit the woman. What was that?
It must be the inside the car.
Oh, is that the passenger?
Yes, the passenger.
Yeah. Word.
Yeah.
I didn't realize it was a passenger in a driverless Uber.
Yeah. See, and the person's like, oh my goodness, yeah. Honestly, yeah, people think I'm joking, you know. Yo, all these robots, yo, watch, yeah. Yo, Terminator is gonna happen, you know. Yo, when the rise of the robots happens, yeah, all them sex dolls, yo, they're gonna turn on man. Get me? Man thinks, yeah, yo, he's gonna get the sex robots to start Quinted. Yo, I was gonna boss him up, you know. It's game over. Robots.
The robot's gonna be like, I told you, wrong hole.
Yo! That is deep, you know, fam. Honestly, yeah. Honestly, yo, people think I'm joking, you know. These sex robots, yeah. A month ago, yeah, we were like, yo, they're gonna happen. And yo, when the robots turn, you're gonna see, yo, all these single guys are gonna go missing.
Single guys going missing.
Yeah.
And all the women are gonna be like, I told y'all. But yeah, man.
Yo, alright. Not to stay too long on it, but did you see the walkie-talkie video?
Yeah.
What do you think?
I thought it was
I still don't
like the tune that much, but the video was good. I like the video. It's it kinda like brings it back to the Soul Train days, and you know, I rate it.
You know what? Okay, you know what?
Drake's hair was funny though. That was funny. And you know what? To be honest, if he was back then, I can imagine his hair like that.
Yeah.
Fully like.
I think it'd be exactly just like that.
I think exactly be like that.
But people would have been like, oh, this video is amazing and that. To be honest, I don't think it's amazing because
I've seen so many do the same thing.
Well, yeah, and it's a parody.
Yeah.
What I would have really liked to say, I don't want to get like critical because I did enjoy what I saw, but if I'm going to be critical, I would have enjoyed it if they didn't have the costumes on.
Yeah.
If it was like the 70s, because you can make the video look 70s with the backdrop and the editing, you know what I mean? The fadeaway shots and the zooming on the disco wall and that kind of stuff. But I would have liked it even more if they had on their original Migos clothes, you get me? And they were just, then it would feel like they're bringing it back. Right now, it just seems like they were mocking/slash parodying it.
Yeah.
It would have been 60s, and then that might inspire some more 70s themed music video, and you could bring back that whole 70s style of shooting.
Yeah.
Oh, no, just a thought. But I did enjoy it, so I'm not really going to harp on it like I don't like it.
Next one. I did enjoy it. I got a deep one to ask in a minute. But this one. Trey Songz boxing up these girls.
You know, I ain't seen nothing about it.
No.
I ain't seen nothing about it.
I'm like, yo.
But he handed himself in, innit?
This is what I don't get, man. It's like, how can you go from the panty dropper? Yeah. Yeah, how can you go from dropping panties to dropping bombs? Yeah. How that work?
They went from it's a the panty dropper to you know, WWE. Oh my god, the panty dropper! Oh my god!
Yo.
Yeah.
I was just like, yo, that don't make sense for me. I'm not sitting there saying the Lionel, but that Lisa Bloom's on it again. She's on all of them.
Yeah.
But hopefully Trey makes it out there just all blessed, because I don't put anything past anybody, but I can't really see Trey punching up chicks. He's a lover, not a fighter. He's never come with beef. Even when Nicky came with the beef to him, he was like, nah, I'm not on that. So I don't really see.
Maybe he's like hawking it, like,
don't get him angry.
Yeah.
But he'd probably say, he'd probably like, you know, say it for the bedroom. Let's say his anger there.
Yeah.
Or he might have actually done that. No. But anyway.
Yeah, I mean, I ain't seen nothing to do with the story. I've literally just heard that he handed himself in. But I got one.
Go on.
Did you hear? You see the switch, and you see I switched it up. Did you hear? Yeah. Go on. Someone applaud. Did you hear?
Okay. No? Go. All right,
cool. All right, so. Did you hear the Kendrick's verse? Kendrick's unreleased verse on that Kanye tune, Father Stretch My Heart or something like that.
The first track on the album.
Second, after the intro.
No, I haven't at least heard it, you know.
Yeah, it got released though.
Why is Kanye letting that out now?
No, I think it leaked. Whoever leaked it, I don't know. To be honest, I don't see why Kanye would leak that himself.
Kanye just put that himself, like, yo, some throwaway tune, but it's gonna get me like a big rollout to my new album.
Could be still, but the way I see it, it's mad because the Kendrick verse is hard and the beat sounds kind of different. It's made me think about, imagine all the hard verses that have been chopped off.
Yeah.
Oh, it's been taken down. Well, Kendrick goes hard still.
Yeah.
And even in the beat's different and that. And to be honest, saying that, I remember hearing like, you know, Famous. I made that bitch famous. Yeah. There was a Young Thug version of it.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, like, imagine all the demo songs that we just haven't heard. I've just gone in lost in the wind on the hard drive, deleted or whatever. There's some gems out there, man.
Right.
But yeah, I was gonna play a bit, but obviously it's been taken down. So.
Right. I saw this on social media. Something about. I do want to hear some feedback from ladies on this. Yeah, because this isn't controversial, but it's like viewpoint. I just want to see a different perspective. Yeah. Now, I saw on social media something about if a man is not paying the rent.
Aww.
A flatmate.
Yeah. So basically, if you're going half on rent with a man, you got a flatmate.
I'm like, what? I don't get it.
It's honest.
Am I lost? I'm lost.
There's some shit on the internet, man.
I'm lost, you know. And the amount of ignorant comments were like, I expect my man to pay the bills, I look after his children, da 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 da. But really, I'm sure he must be able to contribute something. And like, you get me? And it's like, to be honest, yeah, if he's a good man anyway, yeah, he's looking after the kids himself as well.
So
what, go on?
Yo, I don't even know if I want to talk about this, you know?
I want to say it because, yo, some of these chicks, yeah, yo, you're over-entitled, man.
Well, that's
you're too entitled.
Like, but it's weird because it's like this whole equality. There's everyone, like, women are equal and all that kind of stuff. And then there's the whole...
When it suits, you know.
You want to be traditional as well.
Yeah, when it suits. It's like, come on, man. Behave yourself.
But, oh, no.
I'll say it. Yo, ladies, at the end of the day, yeah, I'll say this.
Let me just say, the reason I don't want to say anything, because it's not all ladies, so I don't want to sit here and get angry about the post, knowing that that's probably the minority.
I'll say it.
Yeah.
I don't care. To have a successful relationship,
I would.
You gotta have some give and take. You know what I mean? So really, it's not about sitting there saying, if you don't pay this, we're not in a relationship, it's just friends. Yo, shut up. Behave yourself. I mean, when I move my hand, that does not mean I've hit them. It means just go on, it's a case that you work out your relationship as it works, as it see fit. The time may come where, like, you know, you may not have a job for a certain amount of time, so you can't pay no money for bills. So you're gonna have to pick it up, and you just got to do that. You get me? My man look after the kids and whatever. But yo, it's a relationship. It's not about, like, yo, if you do this. But to be fair, I say that a lot in America. In Latin America, some of these ignorant women.
Yeah, I think it's definitely mainly America.
Yeah.
Because America's, America's all about the money. America is all about the money. And it's like, when you got money over there, it's the thing to flaunt it and buy the big this and buy the big car and whatever have you, woman with the fake tits and all that kind of stuff. Like, it's part of big ass whatever. It's all a part of, that is American culture, if anything. Like, the whole capitalism, materialism and all that kind of stuff, that is America. So the women play into it heavy.
It's weird, man. I find it weird just the fact that they come and say that. And realistically, the end of the day, if you just work with what you got, and because at the end of the day, yo, when you're down and out, you gotta help each other. It's not about no. Can I ask you a question as well?
Yeah.
We're not sitting there yet. Right. Yo. All right. Cool. Look here. Just to make a disclaimer. Yeah. I'm not specifically meaning like you're going to go out there and get like one, but or whatever. Yeah. Okay.
I don't know where this is going.
You know, like the fakeness on social media, like fake booty, fake titties. Do you even care anymore?
What do you mean? Care?
Do you take? Oh, nah. Don't like that. It's not natural.
Hang on, I've always liked them still. No, actually, no. I don't like fake ass. I like fake boobs.
Do you even care?
Care about what?
I think I care less nowadays.
What do you mean care?
Like, you see, like, I get cussed, by, like, I don't know, by Nat.
Nat.
She might say, oh, I can't believe you've liked that picture of, like, such and such X, Y, and Z. It's just fake, man. I said, I get it, but... You know what it is? It's like...
Oh, okay, I know what you
world,
mean now.
The world we're in now, I feel like you can't even escape it no more.
Well, yeah.
It's mad, yeah.
It's common. It's very common now. It's normal almost.
I find it weird, just like... How can I put it? That the average girl now has got fake chests... And
fake lips.
Fake lips. Lip fillers.
Average girls got fake lips.
All that business. And it's just the norm. And I'm like, yo.
I don't get when black girls get fake lips. Or mixed race girls get fake lips. Because a lot of the time, there's lips there already. But they want them to look like Donald Duck. Like, it's just mad. It's like...
I don't get it.
It's just mad.
If they look like... you know, I don't watch EastEnders. But, you know, what's her name, man? Shirley. Shirley from EastEnders.
The older man?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If your lips look like that,
I get it.
Yo, go get some. But otherwise, nah, man, there's no need, man. I think nowadays...
But then, like you just said, it's normal, and I don't even care. Like,
yeah.
It is normal.
It's just normal. It's weird, man. I think it's so weird now, just because I remember back in the day when I was in my teens, and you'd see a boob job from a mile off.
Yeah.
You're like... Yo, them breasts ain't real, you know, stuff. Yo, them breasts ain't real. Yo.
Yo, do you remember how eyebrows used to look back in the day? Eyebrows are mad now, still.
Yo, I'm talking like I've seen some all kinds of shapes and sizes, and I'm just like, yo, what? It looks like some look like they've got caterpillars on their head, on their eyes, above their eyes, and some of them, most girls, to be fair. I know a large number of girls that ain't got no eyebrows, bruv. They're like they've tried an experiment and it's gone wrong. They're like, yo, sack this, man, shave it all off. It's all gone. And then tutus, you just see the pencil line.
Yo, you know the funny thing is, you know, when you see them posts with people, they're like, lads, if you go on the first date, go swimming. Go swimming.
Oh, gosh.
No. I want it, yo. Not for a minute. Actually, hold on. Let me tell you what I say.
He's answering the phone.
Vital.
That's vital.
Yo, fat. I missed it.
As if.
I'll call him back later. All right. Playlist time.
Yeah.
Okay, the hard food playlist. Might play some Tekashi 6ix9ine.
Don't still. Even. Do not even.
Playlist. All right, I know what I'm playing. All right, this tune's called Pull Up by Abra. It's a bit different still.
You're pulling some next level people.
Nah, she's not big in the game like that, but she's big still. It's on a different wave.
Mm.
Definitely like a different wave still. Yo, where's Spock? I hope this camera's recording, you know. But yeah, man, Pull Up, Abra. She got another big tune as well called Fruits.
Yeah.
Bad boy tune.
Don't get pulled down, you know.
Nah, shouldn't do.
Yeah, if this gets pulled down, you know, it's Juicy's fault.
Well, yeah, man. That's Pull Up by Abra. Yeah. I don't know how many people know about that still, but if you didn't know, now you know, nigga! next tune, we should all know about this tune. We should all love this tune as much as I love this tune. It's called Crew by Goldlink. Yeah, the way I love this shit. Oh my god. This is the, you remember last night when I told you that I was drunk and I
yeah.
ran on the window and I just
yeah.
it. This is the tune I was pumping still. I wasn't drunk driving, I had like 3 beers and I was just a bit, yeah.
She see money all around me.
Oh yeah.
Like I'm the man.
Yeah.
Hey. Down another last week.
I'm still vexed I didn't pick this as one of my top 3 tunes for the year, you know.
Mm.
Easy Mac beat me to it.
Girl, and I like I'm your man. You're just a fan. You don't hold me.
Hey.
Better ass nigga with a sick ass mouth and a slick ass flow. Catch up with around me, nigga. And I'm playing when I'm coming for.
Alright, that's enough, Godlink. Yeah. My fair tune. Bad boy tune. Kind of goes under the radar a bit. But real niggas know. This is Studio by Schoolboy Q. Big boy tune, you know. Yo, you know, this album is big, you know. Have you heard the album? Oxymoron.
No.
Bad boy album.
Jeez. I'm just sitting in the studio trying to get to
A. Featuring BJ the Chicago Kid, I should say.
But the song's so fucking dope, girl, it's hard enough for me to play.
I used to blast the remix of this. The Chris Brown Try Songs remix.
Oh, I heard it, you know.
Bad.
Yeah, that air recording is it? Lens are gone in it? The camera.
Oh, yeah.
You know. You depress it, hold it.
Hold it.
Want to take a picture?
No, you press the red button.
Oh, press it once.
Yeah.
Angel out of heaven, such a god is having me pray.
Yeah, man.
Trying to get to you, baby.
Studio by Schoolboy Q for my boy album called Oxymoron. If you heard it already.
Okay. Got fresh, brand new music. So I can't play a lot of it because y'all know they like to pull it down. Yeah. You know me, I'm just write new tunes. But it's Belle and YG. Tune's called 4 Days.
Okay.
Yeah. Can't play a lot of it because they'll pull it down very fast. Right there.
Nah, man, nah, man, pull that up, bloody yo. That's a tune that is. I'm gonna pump that still. Jeez!
Jeez. All right, cool. Can't play too much, man. You know how the SoundCloud bit.
Yeah, man.
But second tune I've been feeling, Black Bunny.
What? I wear that.
By Wale.
I was after
Complicated EP.
Yeah, that EP's alright.
It's alright, man.
Yeah.
I like it a lot.
Yeah. And my girl likes it, so that's always good.
The older you get, man, the more you appreciate. Real bitch. They don't get offended when you say shit, real bitch.
Yeah, that's why I had to get up and press the record on the camera, you know.
Trying to make you feel guilty or not.
Louder. Talk to me different. Let's come up together. Fuck your ex, nigga. If you fuck me better, let's go to Neiman's. Let's go to Lennox. Spend a whole check and run a play to get the
I'm gonna skip it to the chorus.
Let's create the vibe. Let's not take our time. Let's spray paint the new love nostalgia. So as you. She
tell me I got you, watch. Yeah. You know, I want to like Wale, you know, but I don't really like him, you know.
You don't like him?
Mm-mm. I want to like, I don't
you
know.
You don't like Wale?
You know what? I feel like a lot of the time, she was hard still. I did like the CP, but I feel like a lot of the time when he's rapping, he's trying to convince me that he's good.
Like, she didn't like Ambition.
You trying to hear me for my ambition? You know, it's just his rapping style. His rapping style is like, hey, listen to this. I got a punchline. It's just a bit. I don't know.
My third song. I've been feeling this week, to be fair. Is okay, I was gonna pick that one, but I'll save that one. I'll pick this one. Cause sometimes, yeah, if you see my social media, you'll know I've been playing this a lot. And people are probably thinking, Adrian, do you not play anybody else's music?
Is this DMX?
No.
Oh.
Dave East.
Oh no, that's you played.
But yeah, the tune is Found a Way. Big tune, man. I've been feeling it, man.
Nah, for real, do you not play anyone else?
Yes, I do.
Ah, I remember this one. I did like this one.
I've been on a positive vibe, man. Gotta make a way, man. But yeah. I've been feeling that tune this week, man. It's been one of my go-to tunes. You know when you have one in the slow weeks?
What, that tune?
Things just hard.
You know what's good for that? Because last couple of weeks have been like, kind of, not hard, but work's been busy and that. Nipsey also?
Yeah.
Oh, you know, I'm so glad we made that album homework because I probably wouldn't have listened to it, right?
Have rinsed that album.
That album is a go-to for me still.
I have rinsed it.
And if your album's a go-to for me still, that means I'm feeling it. Yeah. I don't really go to many albums.
I keep playing that album. Like, I can play that in the car.
Yeah.
I can play it just before I go to gym. I can play it while I'm training in the gym.
Yeah.
Honestly, yo, I'm telling you, Nipsey Hussle, the album is hard bodied.
Yeah, that's already a contender for album of the year.
It is already a contender because lyrically as well, he's talking bare bars. And even though, I'm gonna play a tune. I don't care. I don't care.
Which one?
track four. I love this tune, you know.
Dedication.
Nah, the one before Dedication. See, that's the thing. I play this tune because the tune, they're like one after the other. I'm like, yeah. This, I literally play this track and then I play Dedication straight after because it follows.
Oh, yeah.
So this is Young Nigga with Puff Daddy. It's just the beeline, man. Nah, it's just hard. I love this tune, you know.
If you're having four picks, I'm having another
pick. All right, then, cool. This is Nipsey Hussle, man. Y'all know. Pull it back. Last time that I checked. Okay, here we go. It's the beeline, man. Yo, this tune is so hard. When I start my cardio in the morning, I'm like, yo, start slow to this part. Yeah. I'm working. Yeah, let's get out of this. You're not tired no more. When the beeline drops, you're awake. You're right. Here we go. Let's go. Yeah. Hard work now. Yo. Mm. Yo, tune's hard, man. Okay. It's gone now. Yeah, man.
Alright, well, let me play my fourth. I'm quite glad we got 14 this week, so. But yeah,
yo, SoundCloud, don't pull it down.
I forgot about this tune, but like, I don't really go to this album to check. But the song's name, the song's called Check, and it's by Young Thug. I can see that bullshit from a mile away. See it. You can step my mother about a mile away. Stack it. I got three white bitches like it's powder day. White. Mink coat with them rolls like a Sharpay. And all of my bitches says they call them Barbies. She looking back like I'm flexing, baby, no way. Uh-huh. And lately, I've been on that juice. But yeah, man.
Yeah, man. I want to talk about another day. What is trap? The definition and sound. Because
did we do this?
No. We didn't. About the specific sound, because in my opinion, there's loads and it can be broken down.
But I'm sure we did when we were talking about T.I. Did we talk about T.I. and trap?
Yeah, but that's one type of his type of trap. Because if you say, because I heard, yeah, Migos said, we play trap music.
Mm.
We make trap music. But trap music, Migos, is not the same as T.I. And it's not.
But it's evolved, isn't it? I'm sure we did this, you know.
We talk about the evolution of trap music. But it's like you look at that and you look at the differences between T.I., Migos, 2 Chainz. And there's so many different people. Because when people sit there and say, oh, Future makes trap music, but Future don't sound like anybody.
All right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, that's
right. We'll say that for another day. Another day.
Yeah. But let's wrap up. Let's not dilly dally.
You found that word.
All right, yo. I've got to start saying this at the start still. Subscribe to the YouTube.
Subscribe everywhere.
Subscribe to the YouTube. Follow us on
not
Instagram.
Literally in the street, though.
Nah, well.
No, I'm putting it out there. Do not follow me in the street. I will probably turn around and give you a jab in your lip.
Yeah.
You can follow Juice.
You can follow me still. Really.
What if someone started following you around the supermarket?
I don't go to the supermarket.
You don't go to the supermarket?
Well, I do go to I go like late, though. I don't do a shop.
I don't do shops.
Oh, just like in the supermarket? You can follow me. I will talk to you if you follow me.
Hello.
Yeah, if you follow me, like
I say, you follow me like 5 aisles.
Yeah, if you're not following me aggressively, then just follow me.
So, what is aggressive following? What is that, like someone literally 3 steps behind you and you can feel their breath on you?
Yeah, and it's like,
you're about to drop something to catch it for you.
Yeah, Butterfingers. Leave it, man. But nah, don't follow me in person stuff. Yeah, man, follow me. Actually, follow Hard Food, man. Follow Hard Food at Hard Food Podcast everywhere. Yeah,
everywhere.
Or subscribe to the YouTube and like and share, man. Yo, what's wrong with you, like, man? Press the share button, man.
Retweet, share the Facebook statuses and all that. Yeah,
yo, it's word of mouth, you know. Podcasts and them things spread good through word of mouth, you know. Share the thing, bud. Press share, press retweet, like the thing, bro. Yeah, just man. Just show you people the minute. Tell them in it. You know what I mean?
Bless.
Yeah, man. And that's the Hard View Podcast.
That is the Hard View Podcast for this week. We'll be back with another round of talking about music and craziness.
Yep. Peace.
Bless up.
Love.
Mohammed.
Bye.
See ya. That's bad.
Right.
How long was that episode?
144.
That's all right.
Yeah, that's all right stuff. Somebody piped me some trap music from about 30 years ago.
Same.
It's exactly the same. Well, I don't know. The rapping, the beats. It was the 808s.
Yeah, 30 years ago. That's like UGK, that.
It was American.
Yeah,
it
probably like
UGK. It was like, what's the Miami sound? That Miami bass.
Miami bass.
It was something similar. And these guys were wearing nice flowery shirts and all sorts of stuff, DJing. It was like, wow. And I was like, this sounds exactly the same as it does now.